for reasons of prestige and due to the externalities of having large liners, European governments still wanted to have passenger lines to America and large, impressive ships. By externalities, I mean spending by travelers that benefited the whole national economy, the jobs created or maintained, the know-how of shipyards, and the necessity to give them work to preserve a national naval capacity that was also useful for military reasons. So the government started to give subsidies to passenger lines and help fund new ships. They all had to do it to stay in the race, because otherwise the age of large liners, or at least the age of first-class travel, would have ended due to the lack of a profitable model. So in this new age of liners, competition between countries for prestige and to show their national genius and engineering capabilities tended to replace the competition between shipping lines that prevailed before. Even though, of course, there was already an element of national pride in ocean liners before 1914. So with the interwar period came a new generation of liners, like the British Queen Mary, the French Normandie, the German Bremen, or the Italian Rex. In this particular period, American lines had a hard time competing because the US government was less inclined to give subsidies, but also the US shot themselves in the foot when it came to transatlantic travel due to prohibition. US liners were considered to be an extension of US territory, so the prohibition of alcohol extended to them, and it cost a big chunk of the transatlantic market.